Hello children, today we'll study about flower. Flower is the reproductive part of a plant and it is most beautiful and the most attractive part of a plant because it is very colorful. Now flowers of different plants are of different shape, sizes and different colors. The function of a flower is to produce fruit and seeds. Now coming to the parts of a flower. A flower usually has four parts or rows, which are as follows, that is calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Just see your four parts, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. These parts are arranged in four rows or concentric rings. The first part, that is a calyx, this is a, just see here in the diagram, figure 1.9. Calyx, it is the outermost roll and it is called as sepals, which are green leaf-like structure. What is the function of this sepal? To protect the inner part of a flower during its bud stage. Now coming to the second part, that is corolla. It is the second roll and it is brightly color and it is called as petals. And these petals are colorful and they are scented. Now what is the function of petals? It protects the reproductive parts of a flower and they also attract bees and butterflies and various insects which help in pollination. Coming to the third part, that is androecium. Now this androecium is the male reproductive part of a plant. It consists of two part, that is stamen. It consists of two part, anther and filament. See, this is the anther and a thin structure, thread like structure. This is called as filament. Coming to the fourth part, that is gynoecium. Gynoecium, it is the female reproductive part of a plant. It consists of three parts. One is the ovary, second is the style and the third is the stigma. Just see here. Now what is the function of this anther? Anther, it consists of a fine particles called as pollen grains. Now these pollen grains contains male reproductive cells or gamete inside it. Now coming to gynoecium, this ovary, it contains small round egg-like structure that is called as ovule, and this ovule contain reproductive cells or gamete inside itself. Now coming to the another part, that is flowers which are attached to the stem by a stalk or a pedicel. Just see here in the diagram, flower is always attached by a stalk. Stalk, another name of a stalk is pedicel. Now some flowers, they do not have a stalk and these are called as sessile flowers. Now these four rows of a flower, they arise from the tip of a pedicel, which is enlarged and flattened, and this enlarged and flattened part is called as thalamus. Just see here in the diagram, this is the thalamus, enlarged and flattened part. So this is all about the parts of a flower. Thank you.